Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to take a look at the analytics section inside of Dashpivot. Now, the idea with the analytics is that it's going to extract some of the data that's recorded in your forms, which will all be stored in the template section, extract that data and visualize it in a way that's meaningful and insightful for you and your team. The way that the analytics section is set up is that you've got a series of dashboards. And you can create as many dashboards as you'd like. Lots of companies opt to create dashboards for different business functions like safety, production, labor, quality, environment, that type of thing. And then within each of those dashboards, you can set up as many charts as you'd like. And those charts could be pulling different information from different templates and visualizing that information in different ways, as we'll see in just a moment. Now, you can create these charts within a specific project team folder, or you can create these charts at a company level. So across all of your projects and all of your teams, pretty much all of your company's data can feed into a single dashboard. So there are three chart types. We're going to look at all three of them. We've got a quantity chart, which is used to track numerical quantities like costs or labor hours or production quantities over time. We've got a frequency chart, which is used to track how often certain forms are being filled out. And then we've got a ratio chart, which helps you to take a set of forms and group them by a chosen variable. So let's take a look at all three. We'll start off by looking at a quantity chart. In this dashboard, we have quite a number of charts, and these are actually all quantity charts just represented in different ways. Let's take a look at the conduit installed chart. Basically, this chart is just showing us the quantity of conduit installed over time. So we can see each day how much conduit was installed, and the different colors in this case represent the different assets that the quantities relate to. Each of the charts has a settings block and a filter block. The settings just allows you to choose specifically which template this information is coming from. You can select what time frame and what interval you want to look at your data through. So whether that's daily or weekly or monthly. And then we've got some visualization options. You might want to show it as a bar chart or a line chart or an area chart. There's a few different options. And then we can choose what to break this down by. And this is what's going to determine what colors are used and what those colors represent. We've also got an S-curve option for quantity charts specifically. And below the settings block, we have a filter block. Which is where we can specify specifically what forms we want to consider in our data set. So in this case, we're only considering the data where the work activity is conduit installed. So that's immediately going to cut out any of the other forms that are looking at work activities that are not related to conduit installed. So we're only going to be looking at that those quantities on here. So the filtering allows us to dive into our data set and refine exactly what we want to see on our chart. And then the settings just sort of allow us to adjust the way that that data is represented. So to quickly show you some of the other charts that we have, I'm going to go back to analytics and we'll go to this safety dashboard. We have a frequency chart here, and we have a couple of ratio charts. Let's take a look at the frequency chart. This is just showing us the volume of forms created over time. So we can see there was one form created on this day, and two on this day, and one on each of these dates here. And the different colors in this case represent different types of observations. And this is based on the information that's captured on our form. Just like the quantity chart, we also have settings and we have a filtering section down the bottom as well. So this is just showing us over time how many forms have been created and then what types of forms are they. And it's a similar deal with the ratio chart. If we open it up, here we can see the ratio chart displayed as a pie chart, and the different colors represent the incident severity. So we can see there's been one for medium, one for large, one for minor. And we could change this variable to be maybe the workflow column that they exist in. So we can see here that it's now showing us that two of the items are closed and one of the item has been created. What's good about these charts is that you can adjust what variable you want the colors to represent, and you can change the way that you want to represent that data as well. So we could display the same information as a vertical bar chart instead of a pie chart. And it again, it's just showing us the ratio of these forms, which are closed, to these forms, which are open or have been created but are not closed yet. So we have some additional help articles and videos that cover each of the chart types in greater detail. It runs through the different settings and the different filtering options that are available. Please feel free to check those out. Or if you have a specific question, you can always reach our live chat team by the website as well. So I hope that this video has been useful, and thanks for watching.